beyond frontier posts. Our world today is at constant search for true happiness, where pleasure and capacity to buy is considered to be the source of happiness, where having more is equal to more happiness, where being self-content is twisted into self-centeredness, where love and charity is reduced to loving oneself. On the contrary, this unique breed of women who in dying to self find life of happiness, wealth and sensual pleasures do not give them happiness. Happiness for them is to be all things to all, going beyond geographical and ethnic boundaries. They possess nothing, yet they give selflessly in love with one common goal in life, to serve God in serving His people. Dare to trod beyond frontier posts to reach the good news to the poor and empower. Franciscan Missionaries of Mary is what they are called. One might wonder, who is the source of this noble innovation, who gave birth to this unique Franciscan spirituality combined with disponibility of Mary for the mission? Blessed Mary of the Passion is the missionary responsible for the foundation of the first women's missionary congregation in the Catholic Church on 6th January 1877 in Tamil Nadu. As a young woman, she moved beyond the boundaries from her homeland, France, to proclaim the good news to the people in India. She daringly took a strange and painful path to go beyond frontier posts and to be God's instrument of peace.
This congregation has its beginning in this Tamil Nadu state. What is started here in a small, in tiny way, has gone to that level, considered to be one of the largest religious congregation of the Catholic Church serving all over the world.
Over 145 years ago, Mary of the Passion sowed the seed and nurtured it with her charism and missionary zeal into a beautiful tree, spreading its branches strong and wide, bearing fruits. Today, FMM are 5,580 in number, from 79 nationalities at the frontier posts of 74 countries present in 5 continents. In India, the FMM are present across the country, divided into 5 provinces. Chennai province is one of them. Chennai province consists of major portion of Tamil Nadu and Andaman Islands. It was founded on 8th September 1888.
Chennai province had its origin in 1888 and the ancient province among the all 5 provinces of India. The hallmark of this province is that it has institutions age-old, more than 100 years, with its own standards. But on the other hand, sisters never had confined themselves within the four walls of the institution. Over the past 132 years of its existence, the province had explored various ways in order to respond to the need of the poor. And it also had evolved with new forms of evangelization.
The mission of the province can be divided into 4 major categories. They are: mission of proclamation, mission of compassion, mission of healing, and mission of empowering women. Mission of proclamation.
Lord, make me an instrument of your peace.
As missionaries ready to go anywhere and to anyone to announce the good news of salvation, we are sent in priority to those to whom Christ has not yet been revealed, and to those among whom the church is least present, giving preference to the poorest, says Mary of the Passion. Even today, the sisters dare to go to the most dangerous and most distant places in order to respond to the need of the local church.
Coming from a different region, you pick up very fast the culture, and then you become one of that. I still remember, there are no place to stay. We are in the establishing infrastructures. We had a kind of shopping, two, three shops together, ordinary temporary structure. The sisters were there and they had to shuttle between that place where they were supposed to work, about 21 kilometers from there. You were going and coming, very tough. It was those days only two buses in the morning, two buses in the evening, nothing more than that.
As a living gospel, the sisters help anyone who come to them and provide spiritual direction. Missionaries Park energizes every FMM community to cooperate in all works embraced by the local church. Through catechism classes, the children are molded to grow in faith. Involvement with the youth animates them to unleash their talents and brings the best in them. Family visits inspire and build a vibrant and loving family and society at large. For the people, they commit their lives, and with the people, they continue their journey. Mission of Compassion. Across the globe, FMM are known for their presence in frontier posts and their involvement in various ministries. Yet, their ultimate joy lies in the ministry of compassion. St. Thomas Mercy Home, Trichy, the home for the destitute, is a home away from home. The inmates here are abandoned by their own family and society. The residents get periodical medical treatment from qualified doctors. They are trained to look after themselves and help the disabled. St. Thomas Babies Home, Chennai, is a home for the orphans and the homeless.
This is one of the ancient mission which started when Mary of the Passion was alive in 1901. We give life for the babies, life and shelter and a home.
நான் இங்கே சின்ன பிள்ளையிலேருந்து வளர்ந்தேன். எஃப்எம்எம் சிஸ்டர்ஸ் தான் எங்களை வளர்த்தாங்க, நல்லா பார்த்துக்கிட்டாங்க. அவங்களே படிக்க வச்சு கல்யாணம் பண்ணி கொடுத்து வீடு கட்டி கொடுத்து இப்போ எனக்கு ஒரு மூணு பிள்ளைங்க இருக்காங்க. இது எங்களுக்கு தாய் வீடு மாதிரி. எல்லா சிஸ்டர்ஸும் எங்கள்கிட்ட பாசமாக இருப்பாங்க. அவங்களுடைய பிளெஸ்ஸிங் இல்லைன்னா நாங்கள் இல்லை.
They accommodate abandoned babies and facilitate adoption process for the children in collaboration with the government organizations. With the collaboration of the Jesuits, the sisters conduct programs for the migrant workers in and around Chennai, giving them support and protection. Amali Seva, Trichy, is a daycare center for the children of domestic workers and daily laborers. They also run a working woman's hostel to accommodate women who cannot afford a shelter. Amali Seva is also a community that takes care of elderly sisters who gracefully step into the evening of their lives. Tribal welfare projects.
I went to the forest area, 7 to 8 kilometers I used to walk. They were living in huts, drinking water, electricity facility, all this, no? They were lacking other things.
அங்கே தங்கிடுவோம். அவங்க கூழோ களியோ எது கொடுக்குறாங்களோ அந்த குடிச்சு வீட்லயே பாயெல்லாம் கிடையாது. அப்போ கோணி பைய அந்த கோணி பையில பட்டுக்குன்னு மழை வந்துச்சுன்னா ஒழிக்குன்னு அப்படியே நாங்கள் பட்டுப்போம்.
From each village, one or two persons I used to take and train them. In that way, I was trying to help them to get their needs.
Their voice for the voiceless has yielded fruits. Today, the tribals have a village and decent houses to live in and education for their children. Legal aid.
I have been working in the Madras High Court for the past 45 years. I am very happy that I had fought for the poor and the deprived and got justice for them in many difficult cases.
Mission of healing. Their mission as healers has a mandate to reach everyone, particularly the vulnerable and marginalized in and around Tiruchirappalli.
Tiruchinagaram thondiya kaalathilirundhu indalavum அந்த தன்மை மாறாமல் ஏழை எளியவர்களுக்கு மிக சிறப்பான ஒரு மருத்துவ வசதியை செய்து தருகிற ஒரு நிறுவனமாக இது இருந்து கொண்டிருக்கிறது.
சைல்ட் ஜீசஸ் ஹாஸ்பிட்டல் இஸ் எ மல்டி ஸ்பெஷாலிட்டி 200 பெட்டட் ஹாஸ்பிட்டல். வி ஹேவ் 250 ஸ்டாஃப்ஸ் ஒர்க்கிங் வித் அஸ்.
என் பையன் இங்கே தான் பிறந்தாரு. அவர் ரொம்ப ப்ரீமெச்சுவர்ட் பேபி. பிறந்தோன்னா அவர் இருப்பாரா உயிரோட இருப்பாரா இல்லையான்றது யாருக்கும் தெரியாது. இன்னும் ஒரு 3 மாத காலங்கள் இங்கே தான் இருந்தாப்ல ஹாஸ்பிட்டலில் இருந்து டெய்லி அவங்க கவனிச்சதுல இன்னைக்கு பையன் நல்லா ஹேல் அண்ட் ஹெல்த்தியாக இருக்கிறாப்ல. இது வந்து இவங்க இல்லைன்னா வந்து என் பையன் உயிரோட இருந்திருக்க முடியாது.
The sisters render their service at a subsidized cost to people from all classes, giving preference to the poorest of the poor.
I've always admired the sincerity and dedication of the FMM sisters. They're rendering yeoman service in the fields of education as well as healthcare. What I am today is due to the efforts of the FMM sisters. They have molded me into the person I am today by instilling in me the values of truth and charity.
That readiness is there to serve our sick people in the hospital. No matter what time it is, even in the middle of the night.
சேனக உதவி செய்யுங்க சிஸ்டர்னா உடனே எனக்கு செய்வாங்க. ஏன்னா நீ கணவர் இல்லாமல் இருக்கிற அப்படின்னு சொல்லி என் பிள்ளை படிப்புக்கோ என் மற்றதுக்கோ என் பிள்ளைங்க கல்யாணத்துக்கும் சரி எனக்கு நல்லா உதவி செஞ்சுருக்காங்க.
இட் இஸ் நாட் மணி மேக்கிங் ஹாஸ்பிட்டல், இட் இஸ் ஒன்லி சர்வீஸ் ஓரியன்ட் ஹாஸ்பிட்டல்.
Child Jesus Hospital extends health services to the slums and rural areas 4 times a week through outreach programs. Mobile health services and free medical camps organized by the hospital benefit the poor and the neglected. Child Jesus Health Center, run by St. Clare's Convent, is an extension of Child Jesus Hospital, Trichy. This center serves people who are deprived of easy access to medical facilities. The sisters in the convent make eco-friendly packets for dispensing medicines. St. Joseph's Leprosy Hospital, Tutukuri. Over the past 72 years, the sisters have assisted this socially neglected group with monetary support and rehabilitation.
Many people admire them because of this availability and willingness to serve the people.
They have hundreds of completely and partially cured persons living in their leprosarium.
எனக்கு வேற எந்த வேலைகளும் வெளியே அவ்வளவா தெரியாது. இங்க வந்த பிறகுதான் இந்த சில வேலைகளை தெரிஞ்சிச்சு. நல்லா சந்தோஷமா இருக்கிறேன். இதுக்கு முக்கியவாசி காரணம் சிஸ்டர்ஸ் தான்.
Reading the science of our times, the sisters began to care for the HIV/AIDS patients. The sisters run projects to provide them with safe environment, supply them adequate nutrition, and help them battle HIV/AIDS. They are provided with seed money to become entrepreneurs.
தையல் மிஷின் கொடுத்தாங்க. என் பிள்ளைகளுக்கு படிப்பு செலவு கொடுத்தாங்க. ரைஸ் கொடுக்குறாங்க. இனிய மாதிரி HIV-ஆல பாதிக்கப்பட்ட ஆளுகளுக்கும் அது யூஸ்ஃபுல்லாக இருந்துகிட்டு இருந்தது.
They also run a dispensary for TB patients in collaboration with the government.
என்னுடைய பணி வந்து அவங்களை விடாமல் மாத்திரை எடுக்க வைக்கிறது என்னுடைய பணி. கிட்டத்தட்ட இந்த ஏரியா 100,000 பாப்புலேஷனை நாங்கள் இதை கவர் பண்ணி இந்த பணியை செய்கிறோம்.
Mission of empowering women. At the time when the institute was born, women in Tamil Nadu were discriminated and never given an opportunity to be educated. Seeing the hopelessness of women, Mary of the Passion wanted to empower them through education, as she was convinced that only education can free them from the shackles of bondage. In the world today, where the gap between the haves and the have-nots has widened, FMM constantly strives to bridge the gap. Therefore, they run schools for the rich and the poor in the same campus. Though the names or medium of education vary, the FMM standard remains the same. St. Thomas Convent, Mailapur houses 3 schools and a ladies' hostel in the same campus. St. Joseph's Primary School, Chennai, was opened on 15th January 1890 for the welfare of the abandoned children of the fisher folk in the neighboring slums. Since many children come hungry in the morning, the sisters provide them breakfast. Post-tsunami, these slums got shifted away from the city. At the request of the school, the government has provided free bus service for these kids. St. Raphael Higher Secondary School was opened in the year 1913. The school gives preference to the downtrodden and focuses on the all-round development of the student community. The sisters take special care of the students who hail from broken families and accompany them.
Since the parents are not gone to the school, they do not know how to bring about the children. Even if we tell them to take care, they are ignorant. So we take even parents' responsibility. We take ways and means to form the child. We will not give them a TC or anything.
உனக்கு நல்ல டேலண்ட் இருக்கு, நீ படிச்சா பாஸ் ஆகலன்னு சொல்லிட்டு எனக்குள்ளேயே ஒரு எண்ணத்தை கொடுத்தாங்க. எனக்கு அப்பதான் என் மேல நம்பிக்கை வந்தது.
The school has contributed a few sports personnel to the country and have received many state and national awards.
I'm a national gold medalist in ball badminton from Rafael School. Now I'm coaching here for the ball badminton game.
Rosary Matriculation Higher Secondary School, started in the year 1950, is one of the premium schools of Chennai.
Students who have passed out of Rosary have been placed in various levels of service in society. Teachers, every year they have orientation program to take them through the year.
The sisters inculcate eco-friendly aptitude in their students. As the motto of all FMM educational institutions go, through truth to charity, the students reach out to the poor and the neglected through various activities. The school takes special care towards mental health of the students through regular counseling. These activities form in them spiritual, social and human values along with academic competence. St. Thomas Ladies Hostel in the campus is meant for working women and students from different colleges. It is yet another way they accompany women not only to achieve higher goals in life but also to celebrate womanhood. St. Dominic's Convent at the foot of St. Thomas Mount runs three schools in the campus. To respond to the need for education in regional medium, St. Helen's Primary School aims at giving uncompromised quality infrastructure to the economically deprived children.
In the classroom, paathina mulka mulka maanavargaludaiya creativity vandu innum adhigapaduradhukaga uruvaakkapatta vaguparada indha vagupara.
The primary school was gradually upgraded to St. Helen's Higher Secondary School. The students are provided a holistic formation through various curricular and extracurricular activities.
At home, they don't have any facility to study and also they are not able to spend money for the tuition. So with the help of the teachers, we make them to study and to get good marks.
St. Dominic's Anglo-Indian Higher Secondary School. Being an Anglo-Indian school, music and dance are the hallmarks of the institution. The school demonstrates a great tradition of imparting quality education. The school grooms the individual talents of the students. Be it sports or cultural, the students are given ample opportunities to excel. Festivity and celebrations enkindle the charm in the school.
The FMM of today are still catering to the girl child of the locality, empowering them, giving them an integral formation, and in different ways a child to bloom beautifully in this Dominic's is the vision of our Mary of the Passion, and that vision we are trying to carry it out in today's society, making Christ known in possible way.
Holy Angels Anglo-Indian Higher Secondary School is the flagship institution of the province, which began in 1888. Being one of the oldest schools in the region, it carries a great heritage of high standards of academic excellence. The school organizes various programs to empower and motivate the students. With the teachers, the sisters constantly work on ways and means to assist the slow learners.
We concentrate on all the slow learners. In the evenings, we used to conduct coaching classes, and through that, they are gaining boosted confidence. We not only concentrate on education, but we give them enough and more training, as well as we send them out so that they will get their confidence outside.
Our Lady's Nursery School was started in the year 1934. This is the entry point for any kid into their life of schooling. To make it a joyful and memorable one, the school takes extra care to make them feel at home. The parents and the teachers have initiated welfare projects for Irular tribal communities and the gypsies called Narikuravar, The sisters visit their villages periodically, render help, and conduct developmental programs.
Sisters, they are very dedicated. I am really wondering how could they are able to do all such things.
First, Holy Angels Mulima vandu 20 varshathukku munadi vandu avanga sisters la vandanga. வந்து பசங்களோட என்கரேஜ் பண்ணி நீங்கள் படித்தா தான் ஃபியூச்சரில் நீங்கள் நல்லா முன்னேற முடியும் சொல்லிட்டு அவங்க வந்து மாதம் மாதம் வந்து நோட் புக்ஸ் பேக்ஸ் அதுன்னு சொல்லி எல்லாமே வந்து கொடுக்குறாங்க. அந்த பால்வடியில் தான் படித்து காலேஜ் முடிச்சுட்டு இப்போ வந்து எங்கள் நானும் என்னுடைய ஒய்ஃபும் சேர்ந்து டியூஷன் சொல்லி கொடுத்துட்ருக்கோம். இப்போ வந்து நான் கவர்மெண்ட்டில் கோஆப்ரேட்டிவ் பேங்க்கில் ஒர்க் பண்ணிட்டுருக்கேன்.
சேக்ரட் ஹார்ட் எய்டட் பிரைமரி ஸ்கூல் தஞ்சாவூர் வாஸ் ஃபவுண்டட் இன் 1928. தி ஸ்கூல் இம்பார்ட் சவுண்ட் எஜுகேஷன் டு தி புவர் சில்ட்ரன் ஆஃப் தி லொக்காலிட்டி. Sacred Heart Nursery and Primary School is an English medium school that is known for its academic excellence along with emphasis in extracurricular activities. Cultural and sports activities develop the hidden potentialities of the students and create the right atmosphere for the development of an integrated personality. Sacred Heart Higher Secondary School began in 1937. This school, just like other FMM schools, stands for its quality and the formation of young girls as matured and responsible women. This community also runs a hostel for the students who are from distant villages to stay on campus and concentrate on studies. The proof of the sisters' care and kindness is manifested in the number of students becoming FMM.
I was one of the boarders. I just admire their way of life and coming together and the community life and the prayer life. God has chosen me and I am happy to be one of them.
As an institution of higher education, Stella Maris College, Chennai, opened its doors on 15th August 1947. The vision of the institution is to prepare young women to continually search for truth, to grow as socially responsible and committed women.
When I came to this college, I was very timid, I was very scared, I was not even able to cope up with my studies. I'm very grateful to the FMM sisters because they have really helped me to come out of my scaredness and my worries, and they have helped me to have an overall development in my life.
The values and commitment and the simplicity, humility taught to me has left an indelible mark in my life, which I'm able to radiate this to my student community.
The college also runs a number of hostels for the students. Apart from a friendly rivalry in sports and cultural events, all the residents are united as one large happy family. School of Nursing is part of Child Jesus Hospital, Trichy. The school aims at educating students with aptitude in art, science and spirit of nursing.
We focus on all-round development of our students, not only academic achievements, but also we give importance to the moral development and character formation.
They are trained to be professionals with sound ethics along with strong spiritual foundation. Community in mission. Community life is a source of strength and builds a strong bond among sisters. Mary of the Passion calls this bond as family spirit. Sisters in the communities are from different nationalities, races, cultures, and linguistic backgrounds. Yet, they shine together as one colorful rainbow. FMM communities are prayerful, caring, and joyful families living together to fulfill one single task, to serve God in serving humanity. Ever invigorated to jump into the work of the mission wholeheartedly, be it washing the dishes in the house or managing a reputed institution, the sisters live with the poor by choice and lead simple lives to follow Christ in the Franciscan way. Inconveniences and sufferings never affect their internal peace and joy. Neither do they get stuck to big institutions. Instead, they are ready to go to dangerous and distant places in order to share the love of God where He is less known. The source of their joy and peace is rooted in their closeness to God. As Mary surrendered herself totally to the will of God, so are the FMM who offer themselves in total disponibility to the action of the Spirit. This is the secret of their joyful community lives, which impels them to reach out to people in the mission. Formation for mission. From the very inception, every FMM is formed and dedicated for the mission. Mary of the Passion says, every Franciscan missionary of Mary, no matter what may be her work, her capacities, her age, or her health, always remains a missionary. FMM formation is a process of growing in the understanding of the Word of God, equipping a person for the mission.
Discerning the vocation of whether I am fit for it or I am called for other life. That is the main thing that we are seeking. I find this present generation very enthusiastic. They have that eagerness to give themselves happily.
Every stage of formation enables the formee to grow as a joyful giver. Daring and disponible in spirit, critical and analytical in thinking, each FMM takes responsibility for her own growth to make new responses to the ever-changing situations and challenges. Going to the roots of their vocation, every young sister seeks to answer this question: what inspires you to be an FMM?
Unity and equality, Franciscan joy, freedom with responsibility,
union with the Lord,
life witness,
daring missionary,
happy and delighted,
Eucharistic adoration,
rich FMM heritage,
walking with the Lord,
Franciscan spirit,
living together,
Mary's HA and Fiat,
spirit of love,
ready always,
zealous for mission.
The Franciscan missionary of Mary enjoys in her self-giving a great peace and an authentic joy which springs from the profound conviction that she has given all to God. Every FMM is sent on missions and is always ready to leave her country, people, culture, language.
As the living cell of the church, every FMM community is at the service of evangelization. One may ask how FMM life is very different from others. Franciscan joy is the fingerprint of every FMM. We FMM all over the world and in Chennai province are givers who are joyfully giving in the community and in the mission.
She is ready to go beyond the frontier posts to be at the service of evangelization. She remains open to recognize the diverse needs of the milieu and accepts people of God beyond color, race, and ethnic difference. At all circumstances, she is available to proclaim the gospel through words and through presence. She takes courage to move beyond. She takes new steps to cross geographical boundaries. She takes new decisions to reach remote places. She takes new roads to reach out to the unreached. She takes risks to make known to the unloved God's love. Let us together move beyond the frontier posts with faith, love, and hope. Dear friend, is God calling you to be part of this endeavor? Do get in touch with us. The Vocation Promoter, St. Thomas Convent, No. 2, Rosary Church Road, Santhome, Chennai, 600004. Call us 9181221 95495. Email us fmmchennai@gmail.com. Visit us www.fmmindia.org.